Has today's fashion industry taken its standards too far? Young women are surrounded by unrealistic expectations throughout their day-to-day lives. Girls as young as 6 are worrying and obsessing over their bodies, and I'm here to find out why. Coming up, I'll be talking to real-life girls to get their views on the current fashion industry, as well as checking out your favourite beauty buys. Meanwhile, I've been searching to find out why so many young women feel pressured to look perfect. Do you feel pressured to look perfect due to the standards of the fashion industry?
I do, because there's so much strain on young girls, to be fair. I don't idolise one particular person, but I find several people inspirational.
What extent would you go to look perfect or to meet the industry standards?
I would diet, but I wouldn't take extreme measures like plastic surgery.
What would you say is your favourite beauty product?
My mascara.
Where does your fashion and beauty inspiration come from? For example, magazines, celebrities or random people?
Mostly celebrities and my friends.
I went to investigate just how many different brands there are on products that, let's face it, all do the same thing. Overall, I counted over 20 different brands of mascara, all with at least 4 different types and styles, 14 different weight loss and diet products, over 25 different eyeshadows, including individual shades, and 32 different brands and shades of foundation. On average, 70% of girls diet between the ages of 9 and 11, and 5% said they stole their parents' diet pill, and 50% said they cut down their food intake. Almost half of teenage girls diet, leading to anorexia in girls as young as 6. Whenever a celebrity has a weight issue or new surgery, good or bad, it's splurged all over our televisions, magazines and computers. But is this really the best way to get our teenagers feeling comfortable in their own bodies? In almost every issue of Look magazine, there's at least one article about a celebrity's botched boob job, new nose job or worrying weight loss. There is, however, the odd piece of good news. Of course, we're all familiar with the antics of Miss Hilton, but it appears even Paris has changed her skinny ways, exercising more, increasing her appetite, and therefore healthily putting on and maintaining her weight. A friend confirmed, she's replaced nights out partying with hours pumping iron at the gym. Then you have the other side, celebrities who drastically put themselves in harm's way for unnecessary reasons. Take Lady Gaga, for example. She may not have had any known surgery, but she's reported to be near enough starving herself. A friend of the star reported, her life is fueled by drugs, booze and a diet of Mars bars and Red Bull.
Sure, celebrities go through these issues just like any other woman can. But the publicity of it all can be too much. These people can afford to seek top-class professional help, whereas most young women or young girls suffer in silence. Suffering in silence can lead to severe illnesses, dodgy procedures, and sometimes even death. The media, however, can help to promote growing issues such as anorexia.
You alright?
Just go away, will you?
Come on, Han, I'm serious. Whatever you want, I'll get it for you.
Hannah, my colleagues and I have decided you need to be admitted to hospital.
Everything's gonna be fine, baby. I promise. Everything's gonna be all right.
A new craze came about a few years ago now. A cheap way to enhance the size of your bum. As we all know, plastic surgery is ridiculously expensive, with prices only starting in the thousands. So, inevitably, the women and the girls who couldn't afford to go and have proper procedures done turned to the cheaper option, with prices that only start around £100.
It has been confirmed by doctors that silicone injections are illegal. They can prove fatal, with reactions including bleeding to death and heart attacks. As sadly, the former Miss Argentina, Solange Magnano, found out. She died 3 days after enduring the illegal jabs. The reality of these effects were unfortunately also met by 20-year-old Claudia Adorotimi. There is the inspirational interview every now and again, such as Jennifer Hudson. After breaking onto the scene in 2006, she was a size 16 and considered overweight. Within a 3-year period, she miraculously shed 5 stone, dropping 3 dress sizes.
I come from a place where we like some kind of meat on our bones. That's what we call it. So I want to make sure I keep the curves.
Jennifer later commented, "I still pick up extra large clothes. I'm not used to the new me." After exploring the effects of dieting and surgery, I visited physiotherapy student Lauren.
My views on plastic surgery are that if the individual is particularly self-conscious or is suffering because of a particular ailment, then it's their choice to change it if they wish to do so. But I think it can definitely go too far in some circumstances. My idols would be women who embrace their curves, such as Jennifer Lopez, Beyonce, Penelope Cruz. My favourite beauty product is moisturiser, because I suffer from very dry skin. My fashion inspiration can come from anything, whether it's a current fashion magazine or an old film, as long as I feel comfortable in what I'm wearing. I think airbrushing, it's a very controversial topic. Obviously, if you're in that kind of media attention, you do want to look what's considered to be perfect, but I think it gives a very negative image to young impressionable girls.
What do you think of when you hear plastic surgery?
Someone wanting to enlarge their boobs, reduce the size of their stomach, or a celebrity in attempt to delay ageing?
Sure, they're all genuine reasons, but teenagers wanting surgery is increasing at an alarming rate.
Due to the pressure of celebrities, 40% of teenage girls would like plastic surgery. 2/3 of these girls were shockingly only 14 years old. Only 8% were happy with their bodies, and 15% thought they were very unattractive. In order to grasp an understanding of the general teenager's opinion, I asked for a couple of their views on the pressure of celebrities and the fashion industry. Sophie's a 17-year-old photography student, and she said, "I don't like how celebrities such as Kim Kardashian are celebrated for being big, when she isn't at all. She just has a full hourglass figure." Chloe, an 18-year-old Leeds University student, has extremely strong opinions on the expectations of women. "I believe that the fashion industry at the moment give the younger generation unrealistic expectations as to what they should look like. The models they use with their ridiculously long legs and size 4 frames give everyone the impression this is how we should be. Magazine after magazine is full of so much Photoshop that you can't even tell how people really look anymore." Teenagers today are forcing themselves into eating disorders, high levels of anxiety and depression due to trying to reach the unreachable. 20-year-old Chris, a student from Nottinghamshire, commented, "I think the fashion, cosmetic and media industries are solely to blame for pushing this view upon women that they have to look a certain way and make them as self-conscious as they are nowadays."
See, even guys don't like these skeleton-like frames girls are coming out with.
You don't need to look like this girl, this one, or even this one. They probably don't even look like that.
So let's stop the dieting, quit longing for surgery in your new face. Just have fun, be healthy, and accept who you are.